For more than a week now, it seems like we can't go a single day without finding out another insane, ever increasingly insane thing that Marjorie Greene believes. But this might be the craziest. So back in November of 2018, California was hit by the worst wildfire in the state's history. We've had many, they've been getting worse thanks to climate change, but the campfire was the worst. It began on November 8th, and according to the California Department of Forestry and Fire Protection, it burned a total of 153,000 acres, destroyed close to 20,000 structures, resulted in 85 civilian fatalities and several firefighter injuries. And it was apparently caused by electrical transmission lines owned and operated by Pacific Gas and Electricity. Scientists have noticed that climate change has worsened wildfires in places like California. So that is the actual explanation. But that is not good enough for some people, including the nation's craziest people, led by their new queen, Marjorie Greene, who believed it was this. Now, that's a gigantic block of text, and so I understand why you would not want to work through that, but we had to read it, and here is what they had to say. There's a bunch of stuff about Governor Brown and trains and how it's convenient that there were fires in California. It's also sort of traditional since they've been getting worse for a long time. But she says, oddly, there are all these people who have said they saw what looked like lasers or blue beams of light. I don't know anything about that, but I do find it really curious. PG&E's partnership with Solaren on space solar generators starting in 2009, they announced the launch into space in March 2018 and maybe even put them up before that. I don't know because I don't actually check things, I just say things. Space solar generators collect the sun's energy and then beam it back to Earth to a transmitter to convert to electricity. The idea is clean energy to replace coal and oil. If they're beaming the sun's energy back to Earth, I'm sure they wouldn't ever miss a transmitter receiving station, right? I mean, mistakes are never made when anything new is invented. What would that look like anyway? A laser beam or light beam coming down to Earth, I guess. Could that cause a fire? I don't know. I hope not. That wouldn't look so good for PG&E, Rothschild Inc., Solaren, or Jerry Brown, who sure to seem fond of PG&E. And so there's a whole bunch of other stuff. But she is saying, I really hope they have very good aim beaming the sun's power down to Earth. But what do I know? I just like to read a lot. But do you? I mean, I guess blogs are writing. It is English language, just letters in a sequence. But that stream of consciousness is Marjorie Taylor Greene, who had been generating some sort of audience online, saying that they accidentally beamed a massive blue laser into California's countryside, and that started the fire. And what evidence does she need for that? That someone saw light in the sky. If only there was a term for like light coming down and hitting somewhere. No one's ever heard of this before, but she has her sources.
The Democrats stripped you of your committee assignments after you were elected. That was raw politics. But in fairness, didn't you also say around that period that you had been a follower of QAnon conspiracy theories and you had rethought this and you were no longer influenced by the group?
Well, like a lot of people today, I had easily gotten sucked into some things I'd seen on the internet, but that was dealt with quickly early on. I never campaigned on those things. That was not something I believed in. That's not what I ran for Congress on. So those are so far in the past.
Oh, Marjorie Taylor Greene with a fresh blowout and a new perspective on Q, but kind of an admission that she did fall down a rabbit hole, that she was just bored and online and middle class and white. And she's no longer part of or believing in the QAnon stuff. And you know, that was the old her. And she didn't campaign on, you know, stopping the pedophiles, but she will occasionally talk about it from time to time. But now we're using groomers. But that was a very interesting turn for Marjorie Taylor Greene. She's trying to run away from it. That was with an interview with Kurtz, I believe his last name is Kurtz, interviewing him for Media Buzz. It's a right wing outlet. It's probably why she was a little bit more forthcoming. Nearly a dozen Republicans joined Democrats to strip Marjorie Taylor Greene of her committee assignments. Remember when that happened? And it was largely due to past comments on her social media pages, which Ms. Greene liked, that explicitly expressed support for murdering political officials, including then Speaker Nancy Pelosi. Fun. Ms. Greene's attempts to distance herself from QAnon largely mirror past statements she's made in the run up to the House vote to condemn her and strip her committee memberships when she fought in vain to stop the impending retribution. Remember, she hasn't really been able to do anything since assuming office. Like Marjorie Taylor Greene is just, again, a meme. She has a podcast, which I'm sure she spends more time on than she does legislating. And so I'm curious going forward, what committees will she be on now? Will she do anything? Do these people even pay attention when they are told this is how a bill becomes a law, i.e. when Schoolhouse Rocks is put on because they will not pay attention to anything else? Woz, what do you think? Is she trying to clean up her image? Is Q done? Like, are we, is that so 2022?
I think a couple of things. You know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of AOC, honestly. And the ability for the establishment to sort of funnel people who are on the fringes into the center. Whip people into line. If you want to advance in your career as a political person, you will have to come to heel. The system is built that way. It's set up that if you want to achieve, if you want to make your time useful here, you got to play ball. And that's all I'm seeing from Marjorie Taylor Greene here. She's like, nah, I kind of like being influential. I kind of like having a voice. I'm going to fall in line and I'm going to play ball. But I'll say this. It's just, you know, just some human sympathy, man. There used to be all kinds of things on the internet that I believed, Francesca. I mean, they used to like kill what? Eminem damn near every other week on the internet. And I thought it was true every single time. I know a lot of black people, especially people in my neighborhood, we'd read these conspiracies about Donna Karen or Tommy Hilfiger went on Oprah allegedly and said that, you know, they hate black people and shouldn't wear their clothes. Somehow this footage never materialized of these people saying these deeply racist things. So I understand how she fell into the Q thing, because I too used to fall victim to internet lies, Francesca.